Congo's leader is blaming a deadly Ebola virus outbreak for the last-minute decision to keep an estimated 1 million voters from the polls in Sunday's long-delayed presidential election, claiming it would be a disaster if someone infects scores or hundreds of others. In an interview with the Associated Press, President Joseph Kabila contradicted his own health officials and experts with the World Health Organization, who have said precautions were taken in collaboration with electoral authorities so people could vote. Those include tons of hand sanitizer, Ebola is spread via infected bodily fluids, and the screening of all voters entering polling stations. Kabila, in his comments Thursday evening, claimed that Ebola could spread as people use voting machines, which require tapping on a touch screen to select candidates. A polling station could have 500 to 600 voters, and this assumes that a lot of people will be contaminated, he said. Health officials have said voters would be told to sanitize their hands before and after voting. Until this week, the Ebola outbreak declared on August 1 had been a challenge but not a barrier to the election. Voting is now delayed in the cities of Beni and Tembo, but not in other communities with confirmed Ebola cases, until March, long after the inauguration of Kabila's successor in January. Residents had largely supported Kabila in past elections, but sentiment has turned in recent years amid persistent insecurity. This latest delay in an election that was meant to occur in late 2016 has angered both residents and the opposition, which accuses the government of trying to ensure that Kabila's preferred successor is elected. Many Congolese believe Kabila will continue to wield power behind the scenes and protect his assets in a country with vast mineral wealth. Protests broke out in Beni for a second day on Friday, with hundreds of people demanding the right to vote on Sunday with the rest of the country. Police and the army used live ammunition and tear gas to disperse the marchers who barricaded streets. Some protesters carried crosses with the words "RIP Kabila" and saying his preferred successor, Emmanuel Ramazani Shadary, will never be our president. A statement by Beni's civil society urged residents to turn out en masse on Sunday. "We don't fear Ebola," one of the marchers, Claude Vianney, told the app. On Thursday,